पापन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड ब्लेसिंग्स टू ऑल द व्यूवर्स ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वर भक्ति चैनल। नमस्कार, हरि ओम। श्रीमद् भगवद गीता फर्स्ट चैप्टर वर्स नंबर 34। एतान्न हन्तुमिच्छामि घ्नतोऽपि मधुसूदन अपि त्रैलोक्यराज्यस्य हेतोः किन्नु महीकृते। Very depressed Arjuna and has made a conclusion not to fight. Etan Dhartarashtran aham na hantum icchami. I don't want to kill these people. Now we are born with innocence. Sometimes every one of us, we think we should have been continued as a young kid or child. We should have not grown. We should have not grown because when you grow, you are surrounded by the problems. I don't know what happens, where it goes wrong. And here it is shown that their own Pandavas' own family, all the cousins, they are nothing but their enemies. Is it life is so? Is there possibility one family, one friends, they can be an enemy in a particular time? Will it be possible? That is the reality of the life. Because we were very innocent when we were in the childhood, we were very happy, we didn't know how to have raga dvesha, likes and dislikes. Slowly we went to schools and colleges. So we had little bit, you know, small fights. Those vengeance might have not continued for long. But after completion of college, education, when we begin the life, then we find something, you know, it's completely, it's new. The life is completely new because we have to face all these unknown factors. Money-oriented problem, family-oriented problem, nation-oriented problems. So we suddenly are aware about so many problems. Sometimes we become so depressed. And when every person after retirement, they feel life is meaningless. Every person after a failure of any relationship, they feel life is meaningless. And all the people who lived and who achieved a lot, then if they don't have anybody to take care of them, they feel life is meaningless. And now, what is exactly meaningful life? Is there any definition? Do any educational system provides that definition? The purpose of life is to give happiness. For that alone, we are digging, making more effort, kept on doing. We study for at least minimum 15 years to get ready for our life to survive. Then, you know, we have to realize what went wrong. Now, can we blame the educational system? We cannot blame. That only one thing is to be realized. we have to understand our system first. Because the mind, the same mind can like an object in the morning, the same mind can hate the same object in the evening. Now mind is having the nature of fluctuation. We have to know how to utilize our buddhi. That is also a particular or an aspect of the mind alone. That buddhi must be introduced properly in the young age itself. Because the mind which is loaded with emotions, that we have seen already, and so many factors from, you know, from all over, from the society, from the family, because you cannot blame your father, because father is surrounded by innumerable problems. We cannot blame anybody in this world, because everybody is caught, everybody is situated in a place from where they are not able to come out. The same thing happened with Arjuna. Now he is totally confused and depressed. He doesn't know whether he thinks properly or not. Because of that, what? He concluded wrongly. He has made a decision that which is very wrong. The first, what he said, I want to see the people who are going to help this evil-minded Duryodhana. Dhartharashtrasya durbuddhehe yuddhe priyachi kirshavaha. That's what he made a statement about Duryodhana. Now he is etan aham na hantum icchami. I am not going to kill these people. If at all I am killed, is it an intelligent decision? This is the decision which is made from a confusion, a confused mind. This is what we do with our life. Often making decision by the situation. We are victimized by incidents, accidents. Therefore what? Our life is having more twisting. Because we just look that point of the time. Temporarily we want to find some solution. Therefore what? We jump one problem to other problem, another problem. Then what? From that problem, we jump from that to one another problem. That's what is keep on going. For that, now you see, we have to capture exactly what happened to Arjuna. He was a normal person because of what? Raga, Shoka, Mohaha. The Vedantic, these technical terms, it has got long meaning to understand, to realize by us. See, raga means desire. The desire itself is not a dangerous thing, because desire, it takes place its own. You are not purposefully bringing the desire. First of all, we have to realize that the mind which is endowed with us, that is like a mirror. Whatever the object comes in front of that, it will show that, it will reflect the object. That is the duty, that is the nature of the mirror. Same thing here, whatever the object comes in front of the mind should generate the thoughts. The mind, that which should have a thought about that object. That is the nature of the mind. See, now the buddhi has to know what to be taken in front, or to be projected himself in front of what object. For example, if you go and stand in front of a mango tree, you look at the mango tree, but say in your mind, I should not have the thought of mango tree. Will it be possible? It won't be possible. When you are in front of the mango tree, you are also looking at the mango tree, you will definitely have the thought of mango tree. Then what? The same mind, if it is occupied or loaded with some other emotions. For example, you are standing in front of the mango tree but occupied with sadful thoughts or some kind of even maybe happiest thought, you may not see that. That is the mind. Now we have to capture completely what is the nature of the mind. That has to be driven or it has to be maintained or guided by the buddhi. First, if we are clear with ourselves, then what? Clear means what? With the goal. What is the goal we should have? The proper goal to be realized. If I am very clear with my goal, I am very clear with my system, then what? I can make a successful relationship that never goes failure. That is the teaching of Bhagavad Gita, but it says in different form, that's all, okay? You don't get confused. See, this Bhagavad Gita, it asks to kill the relatives itself. Krishna also is supporting for that. No. Here, it's a given story. We have to go according to the story to realize it. So, desire is not wrong. Because dharma viruddho kamosmi bharatar, kamosmi bharatar rushabha. Krishna alone has told, I am in the form of desire, that which is not against dharma. Therefore, desire itself is not a dangerous thing. It's not a wrong thing. That has to be clear. Because when we utter raga, shoka, moha, it means what? It feels a dry philosophy. No, the desire itself is not a dangerous thing. That is the clarity one should have. Now here Arjuna is, because of the confused state of mind, he made a wrong decision. And he also continues. He is not stopping here. He continues. Let us continue. He says, Yetan aham na hantum ichhami. That we have seen. Next words. Nihatya dhartarashtrannaha ka priti syajan ardhana papam eva shrayed asman hatvaitana tatayinaha. Dhartarashtran nihatya ka priti naha syad janardana. Ho janardana, by killing these dhartarashtras, the son of dhartarashtras, what the benefit that we would get? He makes the questions. Okay. In the next line itself, he says, Papameva ashrayet asman atatayinaha hatva papameva asman ashrayet. By killing these wrong people, this atatayinaha means there is a very deep meaning. There is a shloka, Agnido garadaschaiva shastrapanir dhanapahaha kshetradara paharaschaiva shadayate hyatadayinaha. Agnidaha, that one who sets fire to others' house, and the garadaha, one who gives poisons to others. Shastrapanihi, one who comes with weapon you when you are unarmed. Shastrapani. Then dhanapahaha, who robs all the worlds from people. Kshetra dara harashchaiva, one who robs these lands and even spouses from others. These six people are called hyatadayinaha, atatayinaha. Now this Duryodhana has then all these six. Even one among these six, one who has committed, called atatayi. By killing those people, we won't get papa. Now he talks about a concept which is papa and punya. It's a concept. That concept, we have to discuss it. I am very serious when I talk about this. But that will give a much more clarity than before which we had. Now here he says that those people are Atatayinaha means those people are wrongdoers. Why? Because Agnidaha means one who sets fire. This Duryodhana set the fire on this wax house where Pandavas used to live. Some prior information they could escape from that. And in the childhood he gave the poison to Bhima. But somehow he was protected. Not only that, he robbed all the wealth from them and not even providing the lands. They also made attempt to rob their wives Draupadi by gambling. Therefore these Atatayanaha, by killing this Atatayanaha, by killing, destroying these bad people, we would get more papa. There where a confused mind is seen. Now, when you kill wrongdoers, being in a position of a king, you won't get papa. That's what the law system says. Now, what is papa? Papa is translated as a sin. No, papa is a fruit of an action. Now, in order to know the meaning about papa, we should know the meaning about punya. If you want to know the meaning about punya, you have to know the meaning about dharma. And if you want to understand what is dharma, you should know what is karma. That's a fantastic way. When you realize what is karma and which is in the form of dharma, which produces punya, that gives well protection from papa. Now the question is, what is dharma? I can give a simple answer for it. An action that which provides punya is called dharma. It has to be supported with lots of examples. I will give. For example, every action has got a fruit. That is the point number one. Okay. Now, action means what? Action means the outcoming from us, from our by our limbs, which is supported by our mind and buddhi with an intention. That can be the action. Even your thought is an action. That's a subtle action. See, every action has got fruit. Okay, point number one. And this action and fruits, you know, it cannot be separated. Point number two. Action and fruit cannot be separated. For example, clap. Clapping is an action. Now, this action, it produces a fruit. That fruit is called sound. Okay. Now, there is no action without fruit. Every action has got fruit. That is the law of the universe. I'm making, you know, very simple way to realize what is dharma. Because dharma has got a huge definition. Dharati anena iti dharmaha. Dharyate anena iti dharmaha. Yagadireva dharmaha. There are so many definitions from our Shastra. But here in simple way we will realize. Action which is outcoming with an intention with the help of all the body, mind, sense complex. When it comes as an action, you are manifesting a fruit, that fruit cannot be separate from action. Now you see, so if I ask you to clap without producing the sound which is the fruit of this action, will it be possible? You try for thousand times? No, it is not possible. Okay, shall we do one thing? Before making action, we will have, is there any chance to plan to separate the fruit from the action? No. Or during the action, you know, during the action, is there any point or any chance to separate the fruit from the action? No. Or after producing the result, is there any chance to separate this fruit and action? No, it is not possible. Therefore, we have to be very clear clarity. Every action has got its own fruit. Then what? Many people, they say that I go to temple for the 10 years, more than 10 years, I'm not finding any result. No, my dear, you will be having result. Because Ishvara is the concept. The God is the concept, that is valuable concept. Okay? And our Shastras are very clever and very deep analysis that which they have. Now this action and fruit cannot be separated. Okay? Understood. Then what the next point is, this every action, when it produces their fruits, those fruit are categorized in two forms. There are two kinds of fruits, I can say in this way. What is that? One is unknown fruit and another is known fruit. How? When a mosquito sits here, you know, this example is given by my guru. It's a fantastic example. We need not to change our example. See, when a mosquito sits here, immediately watch, because always when a mosquito sits, we do meditation on that mosquito. Why? Because this mosquito is going to suck my blood, therefore I am going to kill it. That's what the sankalpa which we have. We make a meditation. And we, very focused way, we make an action. This is an action. Now, the action is performed. The direct means one fruit, which is a direct fruit, immediate fruit is seen, the death of the mosquito. Okay. And where is one more fruit? That one more fruit cannot be seen by you. Because our indriyas, organs, they don't have the capacity to see it. But that fruit is added in your account. What account is it? SBI or HDFC or ICIC bank? And is it maintained by the government? No. It is maintained by an hidden force. But Shastra, he gives the name, that accountant can be called Chitragupta. But that account, it is added in your account. Okay? So what? No. Because that unseen fruit, it will be with you, it will provide or produce a kind of environment by which you will have an experience in your life. Now that experience, it is governed by the intention and the action, or the nature of the action. Now the intention, what? To kill a mosquito. And the nature of action is what? Killing a mosquito. Therefore, you have given a painful experience, means the deathful experience for a creature. We need not to say insect, for a creature. Then what? You will be having a painful experience. That is the point. Instead of killing a mosquito, you protect a dog or you do good thing for others, you give water to a person who is very thirst, then the fruit also it will take. So immediate fruit, the satisfaction of his mind, and he may bless you, but one more account added, that account will bring a happiest experience by bringing different environment in your life. Now, if you are happy at present, it's because of something you have done in the past in the form of karma. The fruit which was unseen, now it is fructifying. Now I bring back that definition. An action that will only generate punya can be called dharma. Okay. Now the concept is very constructive. The infrastructure is very strong. And this is an attempt to understand the law of the universe. Because I made it like a points so that we can understand the system properly. If you understand it, so if you have done a good thing, definitely you can be confident you will get completely good thing alone, need not to be experienced, need not to be worried for that. Okay? Okay. Now the question, which action will fructify punya? Now, the one more point comes, our mind doesn't have the capacity to judge an action, whether it will produce punya or papa. Why, sir? What happened? That's what the nature of our body, it is ignorant for certain things. Because every experience which comes, it comes because of your, means our karma phala. When I experience it, that the process of experiencing with proper attitude itself will lead to another karma phala. That is a kind of a sequence for janmas. We will discuss about it more clearly in the next session. And stick with this topic, it will be very useful with our life. And you will get all doubts removed. Yeah. By Ishwara's grace, we will understand the karma theory, means the theory of dharma. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.